Hey everyone, welcome back to Soundcheck. That intro song you just heard was New Person, Same Old Mistakes by Tame Impala. And with me here today, I have quite the Tame Impala fan, Eli York. Say hello.
Hey guys.
And today we're doing a breakdown of Tame Impala's most famous album, Currents. Do you have any sort of intro thoughts to that, Eli?
I mean, it's a really great album. I would have to say it's my favorite album from him, but he's only released three. He's also released two more albums that were released in, I believe, 2010 and 2011, which is Lonerism and Inner Space, I believe.
I haven't heard of Inner Space, actually. I knew Lonerism was a thing, though.
It's a little bit similar to Currents than Lonerism is, just because it's like have that spacey vibe. Mm-hmm. Currents also has that spacey vibe. And I think he just likes that style. I think he just kind of drifted off into like the rock scene with Lonerism, I believe.
Oh, yeah, that's true. It's a lot more rock, more grounded. Mm-hmm. For those of you who don't know, Tame Impala is really a music project by this guy named Kevin Parker, who's a multi-instrumentalist, and he's from Australia. And but so if you see him on stage and stuff, he tours with, you know, like a touring band, so he hires, you know, guitarists and drums and stuff. But really, all the music is just by him. And it's, particularly on Currents, he, it was released on July 17th in 2015. And this is actually the first album where he played all the instruments, so no collaborations, which is pretty impressive because there's a lot going on there. There's a ton of different instruments and sound effects. And he also mixed it himself, so it's quite an impressive musical feat, really.
What's also impressive is that he adds so many different layers to each of the songs in the album. I mean, you'd have to spend hours picking apart every song in there because, like,
yeah, it's a music critic's
dream. There's so many layers. I mean, he's a genius when it comes to music. He's really a talented artist.
Mm-hmm. And if you couldn't tell, just in terms of genre, or if you can tell from the intro, that is, it's a very I sort of classify it as alt rock or psychedelic rock. It's super spacey, kind of trippy vibe. It's a very chill album, and I like it a lot. So first on the track list is Let It Happen, and I think this is actually one of the more famous songs off the album, isn't it?
Yes. If you go to Spotify, it is actually the second most played song on the album, or just for Tame Impala in general. I think
Which is the first one?
Hmm?
What's the first album?
The first one is The Less I Know The Better, which has a more rock vibe to it. It's kind of out of place in this album, in my opinion. It's more tied into like a rock kind of vibe.
A bit more like Lonerism.
Yeah, it's not my favorite.
Yeah, kind of grunge, garage.
Yeah, it might be
thing.
My least favorite on the album, honestly, because it doesn't really fit. But Let It Happen is the longest song on the album. I believe
it 7 minutes, 46
Yeah, it has
seconds.
The most layers on it. I mean, there's so much to pick apart on this song. It's ridiculous.
It's got like four different sections, I believe.
Yes,
right?
It has four different sections, each with different instruments. I think it's just a really cool song. I mean, what are your thoughts? I mean,
yeah, it's a great opener. It really, I mean, it does a fantastic job of setting the tone, especially since it's got these four different sections that sort of show you different sides of what the rest of the album will be like. So this is sort of almost like a sampling, you know, like a tasting of the rest of the album in a way, because you get sort of all the different styles that he ends up playing with.
Mm-hmm.
And we can play a little bit of it for you here right now. Alrighty, so moving on, we've got Nangs. And this is one of two sort of interlude tracks, if I'm not mistaken, correct?
Yes, you have Nangs and Gossip. So Nangs is all the interludes in this album are different. They all add some sort of different vibe to it. I believe Gossip has more of like a spacey vibe. It's kind of weird, but Nangs is really cool. I kind of enjoyed it. There is
they both got kind of like
it.
The oscillating synth thing going on. So, but they both really serve more as a build-up and less as standalone songs.
Right.
And these are also some of the shortest tracks on the album. Nangs at 1 minute 47 seconds and Gossip at 55 seconds. But then that leads into The Moment. Do you have any thoughts on The Moment? Because honestly, I don't remember which track that is.
I think The Moment, honestly, I wouldn't put it as my few favorite songs on this album.
Yeah, I don't think that one gets a lot of attention.
It doesn't give a lot. I think my favorite on the album, which we'll get to in a minute, is Yes, I'm Changing. New Person,
Me Too,
Same Old
that
Mistakes.
One's great.
I mean, you heard that in the intro. Disciples is a good one. And Reality in Motion is my favorite. But I don't really listen to The Moment a lot. But it does have, all of them have a spacey vibe except for The Less I Know, The Better, which I don't really recommend listening to. But if you want to listen to the rock.
Hold on. As a standalone song, it might be good, but you mean more in the context of the album.
It just doesn't fit in currents.
Yeah.
So.
Okay, I got that. But anyways, right after The Moment is Yes, I'm Changing, and that's my personal favorite track off the album and favorite Tame Impala song. It's just great. It's this really slow, chilled out kind of synth song. Well, that's what, you know, a lot of the album is. But and I like just the lyrics and stuff. It's really great and atmospheric and honestly kind of sad, which is probably why I like it, because I love sad songs.
And it's got like a nice bass. Okay, so let me. I'm a bass player. And all of these songs, you can clearly hear a bass part, whether that be a synth or just a. I'm pretty sure most of them are all like an actual bass guitar.
Yeah, he's got a lot of combo of bass guitar and the synth
and
sort of bass line.
I know what his bass guitar that he uses is a violin bass, which is made by Hofner.
Mm-hmm.
So it has more of a like really, really bassy tone. Like it doesn't have any richness. It's like it's pretty low.
And it's kind of percussive, right?
Yes. It's more of a percussive bass. You don't really use it in a lot of applications, but he uses it really well in all of these songs. And I think Yes, I'm Changing is a perfect example of the bass in it, because I think it's actually in the intro. Like,
it's the
really neat thing he adds to all of these songs, the bass guitar.
Yeah, it's really, I didn't actually know that. So that's really cool tying that, what he uses into the songs very well. But we can also play a bit of Yes, I'm Changing, just because it's like the best track on the album, not gonna lie. All right, so then we've got Eventually and Gossip. We already spoke about Gossip a bit, but we can get a little bit more into The Less I Know, The Better. I know that Eli's been ragging on it so far. although I will say it feels a bit more like a moment of clarity on the album, if that makes sense, because, you know, the album is very hazy. It's very, you know, spaced out. Of course, we've said that a lot. But The Less I Know, The Better, it like Eli said, it's really more of a rock song, like an alt rock song, and so it's kind of cool though, because, you know, it feels almost like the whole album is building up to that point a bit, because that's when, you know, it's just guitar, drums, like really, it does have a really groovy bass line, but it's kind of cool because that's it's kind of where everything comes away, and like here's like a song, you know, no hazy, nothing.
Oh yeah.
And then it sort of goes back into the haziness, but it's a pretty cool moment on the album. And it at least functions very well as sort of a standalone song.
And I really like the guitar part in The Less I Know, The Better and Let It Happen around the 6:14 mark. Both of them have like this little guitar part.
Yeah, his guitar tone's very interesting. I'm not sure which guitar he uses, but comparatively, it's really a very kind of thin tone, which would, in any other application, sound horrible. I mean, like, there's no way I could make that guitar tone sound good. But that's what's so impressive about the album, is that he takes so many different things that you would think even sound bad normally, like maybe the violin bass and stuff like that. And he just makes them work together in really great ways. And that's why it's really cool, because it really brought something new to the music scene.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, it's really great. I just really love the guitar tone. I mean, I think he uses, like, at least 5 different pedals.
Yeah,
I mean, it's ridiculous what he puts on.
I would love to just sit down with him and be like, show me your guitar secrets.
Yeah, I was a little disappointed when I found out it wasn't the bass guitar, because it sounds like you can make that a bass guitar.
Yeah,
tone. It sounds a little bit like a bass.
With how percussive it is, it does sound like a bit like a bass. Although at the same time, I always got the impression that it sounds like he's playing with very thin strings. Since he sort of bends it, like, a lot.
Yeah.
Almost out of tune sometimes, but I'm not actually sure. I should definitely look into that sometime, because I'd love to be able to sort of emulate that.
Yeah, it's a really cool tone.
Then we've got a couple next ones are Past Life, Disciples, and 'Cause I'm a Man. I also really like 'Cause I'm a Man. That one is, I think Past Life is the shorter one. That one's also a bit of an interlude, but... sort of like The Less I Know, The Better, which makes sense since it's right after. It feels a little more clear.
Yeah.
You know, not as hazy as Nangs or Gossip, because it's got a very defined vocal line and also, I think, drums running through it. And so I like those three right there, Past Life, Disciples, and 'Cause I'm a Man. They sound very similar, but I really like all three of those in that section, so I check those out.
Now, just to clarify, his vocals are a little interesting. They're something I've never really heard before in any other artist when they use vocals. He uses like a reverb or like I said before, a spacey vibe to his vocals.
Yeah, I think he uses probably some sort of modulation.
Like they're not
clear. I think it might be chorus. Which makes it sound a little wobbly. And he also sounds sort of like he's got a filter on it, which personally I love. Like, you know, it sounds like he's singing from a room really far away.
And I think in Let It Happen he used a vocoder for the third part of the song. He used that before the guitar part, but all of these songs have that sort of like reverby, spacey vibe in his vocals, and I think that's really cool, because it's kind of new. You haven't really heard something like that before.
Yeah, or especially not nowadays. Psychedelic rock is really not something that's very much in the mainstream.
Right.
So it's cool to see that he was sort of able to break back into the music scene by doing that. And then finally, off the last three songs are Reality in Motion, Love Paranoia, and New Person, Same Old Mistakes, which is actually our intro song. Do you have any commentaries about this sort of closing out the rest of the album?
I think New Person, Same Old Mistakes is a great closer for Currents. I mean, it's got some neat bass lines. It's got like a really awesome synth part in the beginning. I just think the last song is perfect to end it.
Yeah, it's also, it's the second longest song on the album after the first song, Let It Happen, at 6 minutes and 2 seconds. So it's kind of cool that it's got a very deliberate intro and outro.
Yeah.
And both Let It Happen and New Person, Same Old Mistakes feel like they're sort of, they tie the album together, which I think is really important, especially nowadays, is that a lot of popular music, really, the albums aren't really albums. They're just collections of singles in a way. You know, like, they don't really meld together or anything, or maybe they don't have one overlying theme. But Currents is a very good example of where all the songs have an underlying theme, but without it, you know, being too boring either.
So what's cool about Currents is that it has one big theme the entire album. And basically what Parker said about it was that it means like a personal transition and growing older. So like getting into adulthood, which I think really connects to us considering we're both 16 or around.
Actually,
that.
I'm 15.
15. Well, we're around that.
But almost.
So it like really talks. The entire album is him talking about himself. So it's all about Kevin Parker and how he grew up and the heartbreak, I guess. Because I mean, like in some of the songs, he talks about like stuff like that. And I think it's really cool how he says something about how like in a Genius interview, he said it like it's a deep feeling of transition into your psyche. So it's got like that psychedelic feel. So I think that's why he wanted to have that kind of feel in the album.
Yeah, and he has a couple comments actually on specific songs. For instance, Let It Happen, the opener said, it's about finding yourself always in this world of chaos and all this stuff going on around you and always shutting it out because you don't want to be a part of it. But at some point you realize it takes more energy to shut it out than it does to let it happen and be a part of it, which is a pretty cool tie-in, of course, to the name of the song. But also, you can kind of see that with like we were talking about earlier, with the different sections would be sort of like the different phases where, you know, it's all this crazy stuff going on and you're trying to just be alone. But then, you know, the world just ends up washing over you and you get the rest of the album.
And what's interesting about Yes, I'm Changing, which is both our favorites on the album, mm-hmm. is that he said he does not remember making it.
Yeah.
Like he has no clue. He said, a weird experience because it was like it was someone else made the song. I had no memory of imagining it, which is kind
of
interesting.
That's like the trippiest thing ever. I mean, I'm not even like surprised based on like how this album plays.
Mm-hmm.
And also, just to back you up, one last thing. Is that he said himself that The Less I Know The Better should not be on a Tame Impala album because he said it has this dorky white disco funk.
I mean, it just, it's the weirdest, like, if you're listening to the album, it is, it's like so out of place. You're like, am I still on Currents? Am I still listening to this? Because it is so out of place. I don't understand why he didn't release it as a single. I think he just like.
Yeah, it could have done better maybe as a single and not
but
on the album.
I'm glad that he acknowledged that it did not fit.
Yeah, your concerns are well founded. But, you know, I mean, I still think it serves a good purpose in the album. It's sort of like that clear point in the middle, and then it sort of fades back into the wooziness.
Yeah.
But I will agree that it's a little silly, you know, the dorky white disco funk sort of thing. And then last thing, with New Person, Same Old Mistakes, with the closer, he says it actually expresses self-doubt and that the song is meant to sound like the final battle between optimism and pessimism, a confrontation between the side of you that wants to progress and the side of you that wants to stay the same. So it's really interesting.
That all ties into his main theme is like growing older.
Growing older and finding yourself sort of thing. And it's really interesting. It's really everyone can connect to it. And I think it's really an amazing album, especially in the modern era. It's won tons of awards, best rock album, best alternative music album. It was nominated for a Grammy, all this sort of thing. But all in all, it's just a fantastic album. You should go check it out.
Yeah, now we're just waiting for the next album because it was made in 2015.
It's been 4 years.
4 years since he's released something.
Well, hey, Vampire Weekend, all those guys are coming out with music this year. We'll see.
We'll see what happens. Yeah.
Anyway, thanks so much for joining me, Eli.
Thank
you guys for listening to Soundcheck, and I really hope you enjoyed this breakdown of Tame Impala's Currents. Have a great day, and we'll see you next time.